Welcome back to Spello Tutorial Services. Today we're going to talk about writing a complex number in its polar form. And let's take a look at these two equations I have written out. This first equation is a complex number. It's complex because it has a real part and an imaginary part, imaginary signified by the letter I. And this one here is in rectangular form. The second equation, again, is also complex because we have a real part and then an imaginary part. But we also have r's and thetas, which tell us that it's in its polar form. All right, let's take a look at an equation that we're going to show in rectangular form, and then create the polar form. So we have z is equal to negative 1 plus root 3i, and that corresponds to this first equation. We see that a corresponds to negative 1, and we see that root 3 corresponds to b. So using that information, we're going to create a graph so we can visually see what this looks like, and that's also going to help us solve this problem. All right, with the complex plane or coordinate plane, we know that the vertical line is our imaginary numbers, and the horizontal axis is for our real numbers. So we know that the real axis. We're moving negative 1 units. And again, what we draw here doesn't have to be the scale. We're just trying to make sure we're in the proper quadrant. So we'll just say back here is negative 1. So that's negative 1 units. And then we had to move up on the imaginary scale to root 3 units. All right, when we cross-reference these two points, we have a point sitting here. And this point creates this radius that we'll call R, and then we're going to create a special triangle where this altitude is going to be root 3, and I already have the base that I'm showing as negative 1. And eventually we're going to need to know what this angle created here is, but we'll get to that in just a moment. Alright, if we have a right triangle and we have two sides, we know that we can use the Pythagorean theorem to figure out what the third side is, so we're going to use that here. We know r squared is equal to negative 1 squared plus root 3 squared. Well, negative 1 squared is 1, and root 3 squared is 3, and 3 plus 1 evaluates to 4. So we have r squared equals 4, and when we take the square root of both sides, we're left with r is equal to 2. All right, in doing that, we see that we do have the special triangle of negative 1 root 3 2, which says this angle here has to be 60 degrees. All right, if this angle is 60 degrees, we know that the angle here is 80 degrees, and we know that the angle here is 90 degrees. Well, if that's 60, we know that 60 plus 120 would give us the 80 degrees, so we know that our theta is actually 120 degrees. So now we have what r is, and we have what theta is, and we're going to substitute both of those into this second equation. So we have z is equal to 2 times the cosine of 120 degrees plus I sine of, and let me fix that, I sine of 120 degrees. All right, you can leave it in this form, but most of the time, your teacher or instructor will want this in radian measures. So let's go ahead and convert 120 degrees into its radian measure. So we're going to multiply 120 times pi over 180 degrees. Pi over 180 degrees is the same thing as 1. We're just going to show the same number, just in a different form. All right, in doing that, we see that our unit of measure for degrees cancel out, and we're left with 120 pi over 180. I see that both of these are multiples of 60, so 120 divided by 60 is 2, and I'm left with pi, and 180 divided by 60 is 3. So I know that 120 degrees is the same thing as 2 pi over 3 radians, so this can be rewritten as z is equal to 2. Whoops, let me write this a little bit neater. 2 times cosine 2 pi over 3 plus I times sine 2 pi over 3. All right, so there you have it. When we take the rectangular complex number of z equals negative 1 plus root 3i, its polar form is what we just figured. Thank you again for watching another video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe on our YouTube channel, both found under the name Speller Tutorial Services. Thank you.